Now, let us discuss in this present situation as dew point temperature. Then let us discuss in more detail. You share. Now, first of all, what is dew point? What is exactly the dew point temperature? Now, it is the temperature of air recorded by thermometer. By a thermometer. But when the moisture when the moisture of air begins to begins to condense. When the air and vapor mixture is fully saturated. When the air and vapor mixture is fully saturated. Now, in other words, it is the saturation temperature corresponding to the partial vapor, or it is the saturation temperature. It is the pressure corresponding to the partial pressure of water vapor, corresponding to partial pressure of water vapor. Now, but partial pressure of water vapor, PV, is very small. The saturation temperature Thus, the saturation temperature, of vapor is also very small. This makes thus the water vapor here exists in superheated state. Moisture air content is said to be unsaturated air. Thus, moisture present in the air, remains in the superheated state. So first of all, we are recording a thermal temperature of a air vapor, air and air vapor mixture when it starts condensing. So when the air is fully saturated, it is the saturation temperature. It is actually the saturation temperature of partial vapor, pressure of vapor corresponding to partial vapor of vapor air vapor. Is the saturation temperature corresponding to the partial pressure of water vapor. But partial pressure of water vapor is very small. So saturation temperature of water vapor is supposed to be very small. So water at the time of condensing, at the saturation point, it thus becomes superheated state. And most air is said to be unsaturated air. And that the air, moist air contains superheated vapor is said to be in a saturated state, in the unsaturated air, it's said to be unsaturated air. When the partial vapor. So what is the main point? It is what we are discussing, dew point of temperature. What is the definition? It is a temperature of the air which is taken when its moisture content starts condensing, which means we can say that saturation temperature means temperature. So it can be the saturation temperature of the air vapor air mixture corresponding to the partial pressure of water vapor. But the amount of water vapor present in the air is comparatively very small. So the saturation pressure temperature is also partial pressure is also very small. That's the amount is negligible. The partial pressure is also very small. Thus, the saturation temperature becomes very small. As the partial pressure is low, saturation pressure is also low. Thus, most of the moisture present in the air remains in the superheated condition. But this superheated pressure, moist air in the superheated state, supposed to be in an unsaturated condition. So it is not saturated, but it is unsaturated. Let's go. Now, with a sample of unsaturated air containing the superheated water vapor, it cold at constant temperature and the partial pressure of each constituent remains constant until the water vapor reaches the saturated state as shown in point P. So, in case diagram, what is showing here? This temperature here, this is temperature, this is entropy, and we are having a curve between of a curve which shows us the temperature of the dew point, temperature of dry air, or superheated air. This is the temperature shown here. So what is shown? The temperature sample of unsaturated air containing superheated water vapor is cooled at constant pressure. The partial pressure of vapor of partial pressure of water vapor of each constant remains constant, but until the water vapor reaches the saturated state at point P. Here is the saturation point, and the temperature and pressure remain same. So at the point B, it is even saturation point as it is reaches the saturated curve. Now, the first drop of dew will form, hence the temperature at point P is called dew point temperature. So it is called dew point. Further cooling will cause condensation of water vapor beyond this point. So from this, it is clear that we have got a sample of unsaturated vapor. First, what we have discussed, if we measure the temperature of a air and air vapor air mixture at the time of condensation of the vapor, this temperature is given, is known and defined as dew point temperature. And dew point temperature corresponding to the partial pressure of the vapor content. But as the amount of vapor present in this air vapor air mixture is very small, the partial pressure is also small and partial temperature is also very small. So we can say, assume that all this air vapor and mixture, vapor air and vapor mixture contains air at the superheated state. And but the as the partial pressure is very, when the partial pressure is equal to the saturation pressure, the water vapor is in dry condition and then air will be unsaturated air. So water vapor in the air exists in superheated state, most concentrated in such a form. Moisture contents moisture in such a form is says to be unsaturated air. Now, here exists this condition is shown at the point A, where it is the superheated state. And the partial pressure of water vapor is equal to the saturation pressure, PS. PS, when the water vapor is dry condition and where is it saturated condition. The partial pressure water is equal to the saturation pressure of water vapor. When the partial pressure becomes equal to the saturated water vapor, then vapor will say that to be saturated air. Vapor in dry condition and air will be said to be saturated air. Saturated air. In example of unsaturated air containing the superheated water vapor, it is cooled at constant pressure and the partial pressure of each constituent remains constant until the water vapor reaches the saturated state as shown in the point. So it is a sample of unsaturated air. It contains superheated water vapor. It cooled constant pressure and partial pressure of each constituent remains constant. And the water vapor reaches saturated state. When it is cooled slowly, the water vapor reaches slowly in the unsaturated saturated state at point P. Here it was unsaturated, here it was mixture, here it is saturated. When it is cooled slowly, cooled slowly at constant pressure, means it slowly reduces at a point where it is fully saturated. Then at this point, the first drop of form will form. And this point is defined as dew point, as if dew is creating on this particular pressure. Further cooling will cause condensation of pure vapor. So dew point temperature at which the moisture is separated. And as per the constant partial pressure of each constant, each constituent. Now from the above, we see that dew point is the temperature at which the water starts begins to condense. Now, at for saturated air, it's like for saturated air, dry bulb temperature, wet bulb temperature, and dew point temperature is supposed to be same. When it is fully saturated, then it cannot absorb any further. This air content cannot, say, mixture of air and water. When it is fully saturated, then it carries the maximum amount of vapor it can carry. Then if you take the temperature, take temperature of dry bulb temperature and temperature wet bulb temperature and temperature dew point, means at this point when the moisture will start forming, these are all same. Now, first of all, a wet bulb temperature. What is the meaning by first of all, a wet bulb temperature has its bulb covered with a piece of soft silk, soft cloth, or a weak cloth, which is exposed to the air. The lower part of this cloth is dipped in a small basin of water. The water from this silk pit, soft cloth or silk pit, water from the basin, risen up to the cloth and they carry the capillary action and then gets evaporated. It may be not that relative humidity of air is high. If the air contains more air vapor, there will be little evaporation and thus there will be a small cooling effect. In other words, if relative humidity of air is low, the air condensation is high, there will be more evaporation, there will be more cooling effect. So what is the pattern with the wet bulb temperature? Let us discuss again. Let us clarify this matter again. The thermometer bulb is covered with silk film. Lower end is dipped in a cup of water. Okay. It's dipped in a cup of water. And this by capillary action the whole bulb, whole cloth is wet with water. And evaporates, thus absorbing latent heat of evaporation from the bulb. And thus cooling it. If the relative humidity PT of the surrounding air is very high, then very little water will evaporate. And temperature of the thermometer valve will not come down much. But if the air is dry, then much high amount of water will evaporate and the white bulb will be more cooling, that the more will be more cooling effect. Okay, next comes the dew point depression. The dew point depression. It is the difference between the dry bulb temperature and dew point temperature of air. What is the dry bulb temperature and dew point temperature of air? If there is different, then that is the dew point depression. There is relative depression and wet bulb depression. The difference between dry bulb and wet bulb temperature and dew point depression is the relative difference between dry bulb temperature and dew point temperature. Next, there is a psychrometer. There are two main types of psychrometers, but the sling psychrometer, as in figure, this is widely used. It is contains a dry bulb temperature and dry bulb thermometer and a wet bulb thermometer mounted side by side in a protective place which is attached to a handle by a spherical connection so that the case can be easily rotated. The dry bulb is directly exposed to the air, makes a little actual temperature of the air. The dry bulb of the bulb of the wet bulb temperature is covered by a wick, thoroughly wetted by distilled water. The temperature measured by this wick covered by bulb of the thermometer is the temperature of liquid water in the wick and is called wet bulb temperature. Means there are two sets of thermometer. One is totally dry and exposed to the air, and atom is totally covered with silk wick, and which is totally wetted with distilled water. And the temperature difference between this wick covered by is the wet bulb temperature. The temperature which is covered by the dry bulb is called the dry bulb temperature. The sling psychrometer is rotated in the air for approximately 1 minute, after which reading for both the thermometers are taken. Because it is rotated in the atmosphere, so that it has full exposure to the atmosphere everywhere, so it will have a result. This process is repeated several times to ensure that least possible wet bulb temperature is recorded. Next, let us go through the Dalton's law of partial pressures. The total pressure exerted by the mixture of air and water is equal to the sum of the pressures. It is the total pressure exerted by the mixture of air and water vapor is equal to the sum of the pressures which each constituent should exert if occupied the same space by itself. It is a total, first of all, Dalton's law of partial pressure. The total pressure exerted by the mixture of air and water vapor is equal to the sum of the pressures when each constituent will exert if occupied the same space by itself. What is the total pressure of mixture of air? That is the total of mixture pressure of a mixture of air is equal to sum of individual pressure individual pressure of the each constituent and each constituent will exert if occupied the same space by itself, if it occupied by the same space by itself. Achha. So a particular mixture of air and water vapor, say it's occupied in a certain space, so its partial pressure, its total pressure will be the pressure of the constituent, pressure of air and pressure of the moisture separately, when either the pressure in full dry condition and the mixture and or the moisture in full condition occupies the full space, and the amount of pressure they created when while occupying this pressure space is will be added together and get the total pressure. So the barometric pressure of the mixture will be PB of barometric pressure, the partial pressure of air plus partial pressure of vapor. The total pressure exerted by water vapor is equal to the barometric pressure. Total pressure exerted by air and water vapor mixture is equal to the barometric pressure itself. So the barometric pressure is the partial pressure of air by air and partial pressure of water vapor. Let us go through certain more relations. The following new symmetric relations are important. Say, specific humidity, humidity ratio, and moisture content. What is the relation between specific humidity? What is the relation between humidity ratio? What is specific humidity? So if the mass of it is the mass of water vapor, specifically the mass of water vapor present in 1 kg of dry air, generally expressed in terms of grams per kg of dry air, is called specific humidity ratio. If the mass of water present per kg of dry air, present in a per kg of dry vapor, is it 1 kg of dry vapor air mixture, thus it becomes the mass of the mass of water vapor present in 1 kg of dry air in the air vapor air mixture and is equal to g per kg of dry air. It may be defined as the mass of water vapor or the mass of dry air in a given volume of the air vapor mixture. So let P, Pa, Va, Tl, Ma, and Ra all are pressure, volume, temperature, mass, and gas constant relative to for air, and similarly PV, TV, MV, and RV correspond to the values for the water vapor. Pressure, vapor, absolute temperature, mass, and relative constant. So that the dry air and where we have the plastic gas, if the assume dry air and water vapor. For dry air, PA, VA is equal to MA, RA, TA, and for water vapor, PV, TV, MA, MV, RV, TV. How do we know Va is equal to PV? Means volume of air is a volume of vapor. And Ta, temperature of air, is equal to temperature of vapor, is a temperature of dry air, or dry bulb temperature. So these two equations, from 1 and 2, we get PV divided by Pa. Both the volume is cancelling each other. Ma divided by Ra. And RV divided by RA, and TA and TV are cancelling each other. So humidity ratio and the humidity ratio W, MT divided by RA is equal to Ra into PV, Rv into PA. Now, the relative universal gas constant for air is 0.087, and universal gas constant for and gas constant for air is 0.0287 kilojoule per kg per degree Kelvin, and gas constant for vapor is 0.041 kilojoule per kg per Kelvin for the air vapor in the equation. 0.27 divided by 0.461 PV by PA, 0.622 PV divided by A, 0.622 PV, PV by PA. Hence, PV by PV, to PV is the pressure of the air and pressure of the vapor. And what is PV? PV the boiling. Now, consider the unsaturated air, assuming superheated vapor at dry saturated bulb, dry bulb temperature and partial pressure as in figure. So here temperature is given, saturated water vapor line is there. Here everything is unsuperheated. So at the point C, at the point B, it is saturated at dry bulb temperature and dry dew point temperature. It is at point C is dry bulb temperature, at point B is the dew bulb temperature. But if we draw the set line, you will cast this line at the point A, this is where the air is superheated. The air is added to the unsaturated air, the water will evaporate, which will increase the moisture content of the relative specific humidity of the air, and the partial pressure of water vapor is increasing because its content is going increasing, so its pressure is also going on increasing. This will continue until the water vapor becomes saturated, means we are adding and adding more water. Then blood pressure suddenly at one point it becomes saturated, and adds only adds there, yet it is being saturated, and there will be more evaporation of air. The partial pressure PV increases to saturation pressure PS, and its maximum partial pressure of water vapor TD. The air containing moisture in certain state is called unsaturated vapor. The partial saturated vapor, the ratio of maximum specific humidity is equal to WS, so W max is 0.0662, just a PSD over PV minus PC. So, where PS is the partial pressure of air corresponding to saturation temperature. Okay, let us stop it here. What is present?